Good morning. Please stand as we begin our celebration. Join in singing from your bulletin, Bring Forth the Kingdom.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
abundance of your kindness, surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you. Pour out your mercy upon us, departing what conscience dreads, and to give the prayer what does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend, my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He spaded it, cleared it of stones, and planted the choicest vines. Within it, he built a watchtower and hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crops of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge, give it to grazing, break through its wall, let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see, bloodshed. For justice, but hark, the outcry. The word of the Lord.
Our psalm response is, the vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and mind in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received.
received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
He sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally he sent a son to them, thinking, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance." They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. "What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to new other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper time." Jesus said to them, "Do you never read in Scripture, 'The stones the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to people that will produce its fruit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's readings, we've been hearing a lot about the vineyard, and we are living in the midst of the vineyard. God has given us this vineyard to cultivate, to take care of it until the vineyard owner returns. And that vineyard and the person who will return is Christ himself. For many of us, we do wonderful things with the vineyard that has been handed over to us. For many of us, we don't do anything with the vineyard. Many of us, we go about our day-to-day lives and look at it and say, "Well, someone else will take care of that. I don't need to." Well, the problem is we don't have enough people to help take care of the vineyard, and it's being overgrown with weeds and thorn bushes and many other things. What we need are people who are willing to step up to the plate and help cultivate and bear fruit for those who are in need. We need people to help bring light to those who are in darkness. We need those who are willing to step up and help out in the many different churches in which we have. Because there are so many of us who sit back in the pew and I see this every day. "Well, I'm not going to do it because somebody else will take care of it." Well, no one else will take care of it. That's why we need your help. We all have a gift in which we can give to someone else. We all have a gift in which we can give to serve the needs of others. We all have something of ourselves to give or to share among the people. The other day, someone needed help moving furniture. They were burned out of their house. I haven't moved furniture in almost 10 years. I went to help, and then I get there, and I look. I have to carry a couch up a flight of stairs. If you notice, I'm a little bit out of weight, out of shape, and me carrying a couch upstairs was not a very good sight. But it had to be done. Someone had to do it, and I was happy to do it. I almost went into cardiac arrest, but I made it. Now, when I knocked at the door, I noticed gestures and asks, do you have any little ones here? Because I know they speak English. The little heads just pop out into the door, and I'm like, oh, this is a cute little moment here. But I was able to speak to them, and we were able to help them, and we were able to move on. But we brought light to someone who lived in darkness. I have a truck, I have a good strong back, and I have a will and a desire to serve the needs of others. How can you serve others? How can you tend to the Lord's vineyard? How can you be a good co-worker in the vineyard that God has given to us? My dear friends, there is a heavenly banquet that we're all invited to. Some of you have thrown away your invitations. Some of you have misplaced your invitation. Some of you have RSVP'd and are doing what God has asked of you. Where are you in that invitation process? Where do you want to be in the end? Do you want to be sitting at that eternal fire pit, or do you want to sit at the heavenly banquet table with the rest of your friends and family? I don't know about you, but there's AC upstairs. There is none downstairs. Once again, I'm fat. I don't do well with heat. I'm working on trying to get where there's AC. But we all have to work together. We all have to work together in God's vineyard. Let us work together to bring light to this world that lives in darkness.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son has the Lord of the Lord, who has spoken of our hearts. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess from baptism.
Trusting our Heavenly Father, let us offer our prayers for them.
That the teaching and preaching ministry of Pope Francis and all our bishops, priests, and ministers may yield a harvest of compassion and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peacemakers, that their efforts will bring real peace in families, in countries, and between nations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves gathered here in worship, that we will give more of our time to other people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who grieve and mourn, whose lives are shattered, and whose spirits are broken, may find consolation, purpose, and hope among us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in the peace of Christ, especially Mary Jockish, mother of Chris Jockish and sister of Marjorie Kruseman, whose funeral mass will be on October 6th at 1 p.m. at St. Francis and Claire, may she take her place in the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our deceased loved ones, especially Ed Thornburg, may they receive the kingdom prepared for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we now offer in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear the prayers in which we have presented here before you. May they be answered in due time according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept the Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commandments, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which we are pleased to redeem us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them to
us,
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Charles our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and for thy divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace in unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
There will be a virtual confirmation prep orientation meeting this coming Tuesday evening for candidates and parents. If you have the candidate register, please watch your emails for details on this meeting.
And just know that cold and flu season is upon us. If you are sick in any way, shape, or form, stay home. If you are sick in any way, shape, or form, stay home. Because every time you cough or sneeze, I get a text message or an email or a phone call complaints. So stay home if you're sick in any way, shape, or form. That's being a good co-worker in the vineyard of our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Amen.
Have a great day.
Thank you.
your heart.